fantastic. This will be a bit of a different video than some of my others, as I wanted to do a bit more of a personal video, one-on-one with everyone. And I really wanted to put a person to the face. You know, there's a lot of new people around on this channel. You know, hello, and I welcome you. Thank you so much for joining. So I want to get a bit personal with everyone and let you know who I am and what I'm about. So, you know, I released a community post not that long ago to engage with everyone and try and get some questions so you can find out about me. So I've sort of written a small background about myself, and I then got some really lovely questions from some of you that I'll answer in this video. So who am I? My name is Charlie, or if you want to be official, Charles. I'm 23 years old and I live on the south coast of England. I've been married to my beautiful wife for 4 years, and as of recent in November, and we have a beautiful 1.5-year-old baby boy together. By trade, for my job, I am an NPI, so new product introduction test engineer, and I've been doing that, and I've been in the electronics field since I left school, so for about 6 years. And I have an HNC in electrical and electronic engineering. Just a bit of background on me, and you know, if you have any other questions and anything you'd like to know, feel free to ask away. So my first question is from a lovely person named Mariana. Apologies, I've absolutely butchered your name there. And they ask, hello, hope you are doing well. Could you tell us about your favourite books or movies? Yeah, of course I can. So thank you so much for your question. I really, really appreciate it. So, yeah, I think a lot of people my age are in a similar position. The last books I read were when I was in secondary school. So, you know, quite a while ago, really. The last book I read, I think, was the 5th or 6th instalment of the Diary of a Wimpy Kid series. So we're talking a while ago, really. I think I got a full box set for Christmas, you know, when I was in school, and I really enjoyed that series of books. I'd probably say my favourite that I've actually read are the Skullduggery Pleasant book series. I think I read 4 or 5 of those as well. But as I said, I'm not someone to ask about books. I've really struggled to read a book. I'm much more of a movie man, and I'll get into that in a minute. So, you know, I don't think I could tell you the last book I've read cover to cover was in, you know, the last 10 years, to be honest. I've read a few books to start with, some sort of science-based books, because I quite enjoy science. But again, they're in my bedside table. I read the first 3 or 4 chapters, and then I end up just on my phone, like most people. So maybe in the new year, I think I'm gonna try and be better at that, and maybe read some more books. So about now, onto movies. Now as I said, I'm much more of a movie man. I love sitting down and watching a movie, going to the cinema. Absolutely love it. So, my top movies, as you could probably tell from my age, I am obviously a very big fan of the Marvel movies. There is 3 or 4 canvases in my bedroom. I have a comic book in a frame over there. They're all Marvel themed. You know, I'm loving it. I love it, and as you can see from my OD, Stark Industries, which is pretty standard, I think, for my age range and demographic. So, you know, I would put those in some of the top roster of movies. I enjoy the DC sort of counterpart movies. In my sort of top rating in the movie it's an unpopular opinion, and I've had arguments with a couple of my friends about it, but I absolutely adore that movie. I went and saw it on my 7th birthday with my best mate, and I think it's just sort of stayed with me, and I've treasured it, and I've watched every single one of the movies in the cinema since they've come out, and I'm really excited for the new Transformers Primeval, I think it's called, or something like that. Again, that looks amazing. So yeah, I'm really excited for those. My all-time favourite movie is a British cult classic called Hot Fuzz. There should be a graphic on the screen somewhere. Now, some American viewers may not know what this movie is, but if you're English, or you've been in the UK since sort of the 2000s, I think it came out in 2009. It's a film starring Simon Pegg and Nicholas Frost about a village in the country in Stamford, Gloucestershire, and it turns out to be a murderous cult village that is perfect on the outside, and you know, wins a Village of the Year competition. It is probably the funniest movies I've ever watched. Funny enough, I didn't watch it when it came out. I watched it later in life, but it's a movie that I can watch now, and I've watched 1,000 times in the past, and it still has me absolutely belly laughing every single time. I've sat there with a group of my friends watching it, and we just quote every line because it's such a quotable, iconic movie, I think, in British culture in a lot of cases. So if you've never seen or heard of Hot Fuzz, if you have a medium to watch it on, British comedy, give it a watch. It has got sort of a thriller graphic aspect. I think it's rated 18 or 15 in the UK, so do be wary of that, but it is absolutely hilarious. And it's part of the Cornetto trilogy, so Shaun of the Dead, Hot Fuzz and The World's End. And they're all really funny movies, and I enjoy all of them, but Hot Fuzz is probably my favourite. I'd also give the likes of Harry Potter a mention, as sort of up there in my favourite movies. I know, don't come for me, I've not read the books. I know I'm missing a lot of detail by not reading the books. My mum and my brother have read the books cover to cover several times, and I've listened to some of the audiobooks. And I know there's a lot of detail I'm missing. I do understand that. But those movies brought that world to life and have just made something amazing. I've been to the Florida theme park several times, and you know, that Wizarding World is just unbelievable. And I've been to the Warner Brothers studio, the film set where they filmed it all. And it's so immersive, and it's just, yeah, it's incredible. So I'd give that an honorable mention for sure. Next up is a film, a question from Asia. Again, apologies about butchering your name. They've asked, I want to know who are your favourite ASMR artists. By the way, I love your videos very much. Keep it up. I really appreciate that. Thank you. My favourite ASMR artists, similar to yours, there's a gentle whispering ASMR, which is a very popular YouTuber, and I love quite a good amount of her videos and have them sort of saved. And then there's a UK YouTuber, not as popular, but she's called ASMR Angel, and I discovered her quite a while ago, and I think some of her videos are really good, and she's quite entertaining to watch herself. She's Twitch streams and stuff. She's really great. I think for me, the ASMR I personally experience is mainly unintentional. I think the trigger can be reproduced by an ASMR artist, but I think when it's not purposefully manufactured, that's when it really works for me and really, you know, gets my brain fizzing, you know, nicely. And I think there's a, I find it in a lot of, sort of in a lot of different places, so not actual ASMR artists. There's the likes of Kirby Addison, which I'm sure you know, most of the ASMR community would have heard of, who makes absolutely amazing, informative, masterpiece videos. They're so well created and well produced, but they also have some really great ASMR, you know, content to them, and it, you know, it's normally unintentional, or intentionally unintentional, if that makes sense. You know, so sort of that measuring unintentional type of ASMR is what really, really gets me fizzing and up in the old neurons. I also get a lot of triggers from typing, so a lot of coding and programming tutorials will give me ASMR, where there's that kind of debugging and processing and thinking whilst typing away, that really gets me out, gets me sort of tingling away. So those are the kind of videos I will find and watch, both for a personal, you know, I enjoy programming, I've programmed before, but they also give me sort of that ASMR tingle. So I've you know, I have got a lot of those videos saved as well for that purpose. So, you know, I don't follow that many ASMR artists for ASMR per se, so I think that's also a big thing for me. So yeah, that's kind of a bit of background on my tingles and sort of the ASMR I follow, so thank you for that. The next question is from Blog, interesting, and they say, "Hello, I love your videos and I'm wondering what was the moment that made you start an ASMR channel." Well, thank you, I really appreciate your comment, and thank you so much for your question. So I created the ASMR channel CD Tingles ASMR back in 2021, early doors of 2021, and I think it was on sort of a whim of, I've been creating YouTube channels since probably, I think I started my first YouTube channel in 2010. I think I was uploading it from when I was like 11 or 12, you know, making God knows what videos, chatting rubbish, just making videos, and I've been doing that for years. I've made all different types of genres of videos, you know, I've made vlog style, skit style, gaming, those, you know, all the kind of standard norms, and I did them and nothing ever stuck. Nothing ever stuck, so I always gave up. But ASMR had always been something I'd experienced and enjoyed, and you know, I'd been in the community for ages, and I think I was just sat at home during, you know, working from home, and I created the channel, and I was like, you know what, let's give it a go. And there was no sort of one moment that I was like, I'm gonna do this. I had made so many channels, I was like, I'm gonna give this a go because I enjoy it. I have, you know, a personal sort of belief in it, and I experienced it. So if I can try and recreate how I get tingles, maybe I can do that for someone else, if that makes sense. So yeah, that's kind of where I went. And so I created the channel. I tried making a video to start with, and it failed. The noise was rubbish, I couldn't film it properly, and it never got uploaded. I never made it, and I gave up, and I was like, I can't do it, it's too difficult. And a couple of weeks went by, and I kind of got back around, worked out a better way of doing it, and I filmed it. And that first video is viewable on my channel. I'm making a 3D bust of your face, something like that. And in something like 24 or 48 hours, that video had like 200 views. Now, for some people, that's not a lot, but for me, I was used to like 5 or 6 or 12 or 13 views on a video. June 2021. I have the computer I had to hang up socialising for a good few months. And, you know, I wanted to focus on being a new dad and, you know, taking care of my wife who'd just gone through an absolutely life-changing event. So, you know, I didn't have the brain capacity, I didn't have the determination, it didn't cross my mind. And it wasn't until I was on a stopgap between jobs in September that I kind of reevaluated and went, you know, I want to do this again. I did upload a crappy video that I was so pointless to film. I just uploaded it for the sake of it, and it was, you know, irrelevant. I thought, I'm going to give this a go again. In September this year, 2022, I started to come up with ideas. I effectively branded the channel, created the logo and the little watermark, a stupid picture of my face in the corner, and I thought, I'm gonna try this. And I was like, and I came up with a list of ideas I was going to do. And since then I've tried my hardest to upload fairly consistently. I've not uploaded as consistent as I'd like to have uploaded, but I've kept at it, and the feedback and the reception these videos have got has been unbelievable. You know, I thought my mates would laugh at me when I, because ASMR has a stigma in people that don't experience it, and, you know, I thought my mates would make fun of me for it, but they've actually been so supportive because they can see that I love it, and, you know, you can see that people are also loving it, you know. And my wife has been so supportive of me making these. She's always like, oh, you know, what's your next video, what are you going to record next, when are you uploading next, which is really helped. You know, seeing everyone's absolutely amazing comments has really, really helped push me to keep uploading and really make something of this channel. You know, I do struggle because I have to film these at, you know, 9 o'clock at night to try and limit noise problems and, you know, make sure people are in bed, you know, to try and get the right atmosphere for these videos. And, you know, I have to get up at 6 a.m. for work, so I want to film these well and give it, you know, the right amount of time and energy to make a good video. But I also don't want to risk, you know, having it, you know, get up late for work or you know, not filming a good video. So I have missed a few weeks, and that's purely because I've either been really tired or, you know, I've been struggling to come up with motivation. I think everyone gets that, especially where it's been, you know, the weather's been dropping and hot, you know, getting really cold, so it's really hard to kind of get up and get motivated because you just want to sit under a blanket and be nice and warm. But we're coming to Christmas and I'm feeling really good, and I've got loads on my list for what I want to do. I think in the new year I'm gonna purchase myself, or for Christmas, January sales, whatever works out best, it's like a portable Bluetooth lovely microphone, which from what I can see online does really well for ASMR, because I want to film in different places than my office. In this corner here it's just, you know, stuff is kind of loft, so my background's gonna be, is always a mess. Or I've got my obsessive collection of Monopolies there. You know, so I want to film like that in different locations, so I can make a more immersive video for everyone, and I can be a bit more sort of care. Yeah, I can do a bit more with the camera work and whatnot. So I'm gonna hopefully be able to treat myself in the new year to a new microphone, and, you know, hopefully in sort of 6 months' time, so I can buy a proper camera, because at the moment I'll be filming things. the phone camera's great and it works absolutely fine. I just, you know, means I have to delete them off my phone, possibly lose them and stuff like that. You know, so there's, you know, I've got a lot of plans of what I want to do and what I want to achieve on this channel. And, you know, I want to bring everyone along with me on that journey. And I want to be making these Q&As, if I can, monthly, just so I can continue this communication with my audience, because it's you guys that are making me want to continue and you know, pushing me to make better and for the inner future, even more content. So I thank you so much for giving me the questions, people that communicate to my community posts. And if you have any more questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, and I'll be more than happy to keep those and lock them in for the next Q&A, which will probably be after Christmas, if you'd like that. I'll probably do some community posts in the meantime, and you maybe put out some videos.